wabarakatuh.
Guys, welcome back with me, Mr. Ok, in English Conversation Class. Are you feeling good today? I hope you're always under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Guys, today we are going to focus on three simple expressions. So are you ready for that? Let's break the limit!
But before we study, it's better for us to have a pray. So let's pray together.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Rabbi zidni ilma warzuqni fahma.
Okay guys, let's get started. So guys,
our today's materials are expressing pain, expressing relief, and expressing sympathy. So what are they, sir? Apa itu expressing pain, relief, dan sympathy? Before we dig deeper, Mr. will tell you the basic competence and indicator of this lesson. So after studying these materials, Mr. hopes you as the students are able to respond within the meaning of transactional conversation
to get things done and interpersonal or social and formal ongoing or sustained accurately, fluently, and appreciate the use of different language spoken in the context of daily life and involves the speech act. Mr. hopes all of you can use the expressions of pain, relief, and sympathy and to respond the use of expressing sympathy, relief, and pain. Okay guys, sekarang kita bahas satu persatu dari ketiga materi tersebut. Okay, yang pertama, expressing pain. When we get sick, we must feel pain on our part of body. When we get an accident and when we must injured because of it, we must feel pain too. Jadi pada saat kita sakit, kita pasti merasakan kepedihan, kesakitan pada anggota tubuh kita. Begitupun pada saat kita have an accident, ya, kita juga merasa sakit. So expressing pain is an unpleasant sensation occurring in varying degrees of severity as a consequence of injury, disease, or emotional disorder. Jadi intinya expressing pain ini adalah ungkapan yang digunakan pada saat kita merasa sakit, pedih, perih terhadap sesuatu. Nah, berikut ini adalah ungkapan yang bisa kita gunakan pada saat kita ingin menyatakan sakit dalam bahasa Inggris. We can say, ouch, it's painful, that's painful, it hurts me, it's really painful, it's killing me, I can't stand it anymore, my eyes ache, my body aches, my stomach ache, my headache, it's getting worse, my pain drives me crazy, it's awful. Please do something. I can't hold this for any longer. That's sore. Help me. I feel sick. Don't pinch me. It hurts. It's more than usual sick. I don't feel well. Nah guys, itulah beberapa ungkapan yang bisa kita gunakan pada saat kita merasa sakit ya. Biasanya ungkapan ini bisa kita ungkapkan dengan ekspresi yang pucat, yang sakit, yang lemas, ataupun bisa juga dengan ekspresi yang menggebu-gebu bahwa itu benar-benar sakit, jadi dia kesannya agak sedikit marah. Nah, berikut ini ada contoh dialog yang bisa kita aplikasikan dari beberapa ungkapan tadi. Contohnya, Andy,
are you okay?
James,
ouch, that hurts.
Andy,
let me help you.
James,
thanks.
Andy,
you should be more careful.
Nah, gitu ya. Jadi itulah expressing pain dan penggunaannya. I hope you can get it. Now, kita lanjut pada expressing yang kedua, yaitu expressing sympathy.
So, expression of sympathy is an expression that we can use when we want to show our sympathy or care to someone or something that experiences pain, injury, unpleasant thing, or bad news.
Nah, berikut ini adalah ungkapan-ungkapan yang bisa kalian gunakan. Yang pertama, I know how you feel. I know how it feels. I know how it hurts. I take sympathy on you. I sympathize. Let me help you. What happens? What's wrong with you? What is your problem? Please tell me why. Would you very pleased to share? Do you mind to tell me about it? Kemudian bisa juga diucapkan dengan That's too bad. That's so bad. I'm sorry. What bad luck. I hope things get better soon. It would be okay soon. I hope you feel better soon. What a pity. Be patient. It would be better soon. Oh, that's terrible. I can't tell you how sorry I am.
Oh, I am sorry to hear that. I know how it feels. I take my sympathy to you. You must be very upset about it. I sympathize with your condition.
Nah, sekarang kita lihat penggunaan expressions tersebut ke dalam suatu dialog. Hi Jen, you look so sad today. What happened?
My brother hospitalized this morning.
I am sorry to hear that. I hope he will get better soon.
I hope so. Thank you for your kind words.
Nah guys, itulah expressions of sympathy. I hope you can get the point. Jadi bisa kita tarik kesimpulan bahwa expressions of sympathy itu adalah ungkapan yang digunakan pada saat kita ingin bersimpati, bahwa kita ingin membersamai kesedihan seseorang, bahwa kita itu care, kita peduli terhadap kesedihan seseorang gitu. Nah, kemudian yang ketiga yaitu ialah expressing relief. Expressing relief is a feeling of cheerfulness or optimism that follows the removal of anxiety, pain or distress. When we have problem, then we can solve it. We will feel a relief. In other situation, when we feel worried about something that we will face, and then we can face it, we will also feel relief. Jadi intinya, expressing relief itu adalah ungkapan yang digunakan pada saat kita lega. Nah, berikut ini adalah beberapa ungkapan-ungkapannya. Yang pertama, what a relief. That's a relief. I'm relieved. I'm very relieved to hear that. I'm glad it's done. Phew. Thanks God. Thanks goodness. Thanks God to hear that. Oh, good. It's very relaxing. Good for you. I don't believe it. Thanks. It's really pleasant. That's marvelous. I'm glad everything is running well. I'm extremely happy to hear that. That was unpredictable. Good fortune. Nah, guys, berikut ini adalah penerapan dalam bentuk dialog.
Finally, we finished our high school year. That was a relief.
Nah, gitu ya. Itulah expressions of relief. Jadi digunakan pada saat kita lega. Jadi pada saat problem yang kita hadapi selesai atau pain yang kita rasakan itu mulai sedikit berangsur membaik, nah kita merasakan kelegaan tersebut. Oke. Pahamnya sampai sini? Oke, guys, maybe that's enough. Jadi itulah tiga expressions yang telah kita pelajari. Yang pertama, expressing pain, kemudian expressing sympathy, dan yang terakhir adalah expressing relief. I hope you can understand. If you have something that puzzles you, you may question Mr. on personal chat. Okay, maybe that's enough. Thanks for your time. Thanks for your attention. Mr. Akhiri, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye-bye.